Percutaneous Dilation Tracheostomy has become established as a standard technique in intensive care practice. The Chalia technique is widely used. The Tracoe Experc Dilation Set includes compresses, a syringe, a puncture needle with Teflon catheter, a safety scalpel, the blue predilator, a kink-resistant guide wire made of nitinol according to the Zeldinger technique, and the green Experc dilator with hydrophilic coating and guiding catheter with safety stop. Set the bed flat and position the patient supine with a roll of bed sheets or a pillow beneath the shoulders, under the neck below the base of the skull, so that the head and neck are fully extended. Stabilize the head and neck. The patient's internal and external anatomy should be examined for anatomical anomalies that may adversely affect this procedure. Sedate the patient and monitor in accordance with hospital guidelines. Disinfect the skin in the neck region and cover it with sterile drapes. The initial puncture typically is performed between the second and third or third and fourth cartilage ring. Identify and mark the landmarks. To prevent the endotracheal tube from being pierced, withdraw the ET tube with a deflated cuff as far as below the vocal folds. The cuff of the ET tube should then be reinflated, cuff pressure controlled, and ventilation adjusted. The area is locally anesthetized. Then a 1.5 to 2 centimeter incision is made on the midline according to the patient's set landmarks. Fill the syringe partially with sterile saline solution or sterile water and then attach it to the puncture needle within the Teflon catheter. Start vertically in the puncture area. Push the puncture needle forward in a posterior caudal direction until air bubbles can be visualized in the syringe. This indicates the tip of the needle is in the air-filled trachea. At this time, the needle and syringe are tilted at an angle of 60 degrees to the anterior wall of the trachea. After the air is visualized freely, remove the puncture needle together with the syringe from the Teflon catheter. Now, insert the Zeldinger guide wire by placing the introducer on the Teflon catheter and carefully push the guide wire through. The guide wire should be advanced up to its first marking, approximately 10 centimeters into the trachea. Once this is complete, remove the Teflon catheter over the guide wire. Insert the short blue predilator over the guide wire and into the trachea to predilate the puncture site. Then remove it while securing the guide wire in place. Moisten the Experc dilator with sterile saline solution or sterile water immediately before the insertion to activate the hydrophilic coating to the maximum insertion mark. Push the pre-assembled guiding catheter with the Experc dilator over the guide wire until the safety stop of the guiding catheter reaches skin level. Now, visually check the mark at the end of the guide wire. Make sure that the marking of the guide wire is visible even after sliding on the Experc dilator with guiding catheter. Start inserting the dilator vertically to widen the stoma. Gently advance the dilator into the trachea with a controlled motion. There are markings on the dilator at 38 French and 41 French for guidance. The 38 French marking should be visible in the lumen of the trachea using the bronchoscope. Remove the Experc dilator. A tracheostomy tube suitable for the patient should now be placed.